Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you how to batch process images using Preview. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So let's say you want to change the size or the format of a group of image files. Doing this is called batch processing, and most image apps like Photoshop have this ability. However, you can also do it with the built-in Preview app on your Mac. So let's say I've got these images here. Now, if I were to select one of these images and look at the information, I could see it's 4,032 pixels wide. It's a JPEG image. And if I were to double click on it, it would open up in Preview by default. And then I could go to Tools and I could adjust the size and change the size. I could also go to File and then Export, and then export a new copy in a different format, perhaps reducing the file size considerably. But what if I wanted to do it for a whole bunch of files? I've got 5 here, but maybe you have 50 or 500 images. You can use Preview to batch process all of these. So the first thing you want to do is select them all. You can use Shift click to select them all on the list here. I'm just going to use Command A since I want every file that's in this folder. And now I'm going to open them. I could just double click on one since they're all selected. They should all open in the default app, which is Preview. Or I could use Command O, which is File Open. Then you'll see they open in Preview. And what you're going to look for is a sidebar that shows you all the images. So they open in one window, not in tabs, this one window here with all the images listed on the left. Now, if that doesn't happen, it may be because of your settings. For instance, if I go to Preview Settings here and then go to Images, you could see when opening files, if I have it set to open each file in its own window, then opening all of these will open every single one in its own window, and you can't use this technique. So you want to set it to open groups of files in the same window or open all files in one window. And now when you open them, it should open one window with each of the images here on the left, and you can switch which image you're looking at. Better still, you can select more than one image. You can select one image and then Command click to select another one, or you can select one image and Shift click to select a range, or you could just use Command A and it selects them all. That's a keyboard shortcut for Edit, Select All. So now with all of these selected, you could actually go in and change all of them at once. If I were to go to Tools and then Adjust Size, you can see it gives me the size of all the images. In this case, they're all the same. If not, it would just give me the first one. And then I could set it to something else. So I'll change it to 3,000 pixels wide. And you can see here a summary. You can see it's going to change the size to 74.4% of the original, and that there are 5 images it's going to change. So you can see here it's going to be 12.7 megs down from 17.7 megs. Now, if I click OK, you can see it's done. I don't have to save or anything. It's automatically saved. So I can close this window here, and now I can look at these files, and if I select the first one, you can see it's now 3,000 pixels wide. Now you can do other things with the same technique as well. So I'll open all of these again, do Command A to select them all. Notice that if I go to Tools and then Rotate, I can rotate all of them. I'm going to use Command Z to undo that. Other tools will work as well, such as the Flip tools here. But adjusting color won't work. If I go in here and I change, say, the exposure to make this darker, you can see it just changes that one image. But what will work is exporting. So I have all these selected here, and if I go to File and then Export Selected Images, then I can choose a location, and I can also show options. So I can change the format. So let's use the newer HEIC format here. I can change the quality. It's going to give me an estimate here of the quality for one of the files. And let's put it right there in the middle. And then I will choose. And now it's going to export. If I look in the Finder now, I'll see my originals. I decided to save these in the same location. So now I see the new ones right next to it. And you can see that it's the same dimensions, but the better compression I'm getting with HEIC has made the files much smaller. So this is a great technique to use, say if you want to share a bunch of images with somebody or upload them online. You can first reduce the dimensions and then export maybe with higher compression levels and get smaller files and do it with a whole batch of them at once. Now do note that when you change dimensions or when you rotate images, it's going to automatically save these. So if you want to keep the originals, you first want to duplicate all the images or duplicate the folder they're in and make the changes to the new copies, leaving your originals untouched. I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.